This is Dr. Sivan. I will be recapping the earlier steps of the problem we are solving of circular water tank with flexible base. Here we got the capacity is given, depth of the water, then freeboard is also given, and then grade of the concrete, that is M20. So we, in the last video, we have just gone through calculation of diameter, then calculation of hook seal, and then area of the hook seal, then we have calculated the spacing, and then actual area of the hook seal. So now we'll be going to the next step, number 3. So step number 3 is to calculate thickness. Thickness of wall. So we are going to calculate how much thickness we need here. So the formula is empirical formula, which is given in the many books. Suppose if T is the thickness of wall, so in that case, that is sigma CT, that is the formula which is given by WH D by 2 divided by 1000 T plus M minus 1 into AFH. So here sigma CT, it is the permissible direct tensile stress, and for M20 grade of concrete it is 1.2. So here we can write down this sigma CT. This is permissible direct tensile stress, and that is equals to 1.2 newton per mm square for M20 grade of the concrete. Now here modular ratio, so modular ratio directly we can just take it from the annexure B of IS 456, or we know it for M20 grade of the concrete, that is 13.33. So here we can write down sigma CT, as we know, that is 1.2, and that is equals to WHD by 2, that is T max, nothing but, which we have calculated earlier case. So this is, we have calculated here T max WHD by 2. So here we can write down directly 229.32 into 10 raised to the power 3. So we convert it into of Newton. Then 1000 into T plus M, it is 13.33 minus 1. Multiplied by ASH, we got it here 2093. So this is going to be 2093, and from this you will get T, if you just calculate it around, so you will get it T around 170 mm. So this is how we have calculated 170 mm sigma CT for If you just look at the earlier videos, in that case, I have just given certain tables and explained those, and that you will get this permissible direct tensile stress for different grade of the concrete. Now, in this case, we got it thickness as 170 mm. So, once we calculated thickness, okay, in that case, we'll go for the next one. There is again another empirical formula that T thickness we can just directly calculate as 30 into H plus 50. So that will give you in terms of mm, where H is the height of water retained in meter. You can write down H equals height of water retained in meter, and this T you will get it in terms of mm. So here H we got it around 4 meter, that is actually height of water retained, so that is we already covered at that height of water retained, that is effective depth of the water, and that is 3.8 meter, right? So if you just calculate it, you will get it around 170 mm. Okay, so you can write down, therefore providing thickness of wall as 170 mm. So here we got the thickness of wall as 170 mm. So now what we can do? So that is the step number 3. Now we'll go for the step number 4, where we are going to calculate front spacing at the different height. So let us say step number 4. Calculation of ASH at different depth. So calculation of ASH at the different depth. So we will calculate, let us say, at the depth of 2 meter below the top. At 2 meter below the top. So we'll just calculate directly ASH is equal to, that is WH D by 2 divided by sigma S. That is T max, actually. T max we have just instead of calculating hook tension, you just directly going to the calculation of area of steel. So this is 9.8 into 10 raised to the power 3 multiplied by h, it is 2 meters, so we can just write down here 2 multiplied by 11.7. So 11.7, that is the diameter we got it here, 11.7. Okay. So 11.7. And this is divided by 2. So it is 115. So therefore, ASF, if you just calculate this, you will get it around 997 mm². So again, we can calculate the spacing. So spacing is equal to, you know, that is the area of one bar. It, we are already providing. If we just look at the earlier step, step number 2, where we have already calculated, we have to use 20 mm diameter bar, where we got area of one bar, that is 314 mm², and spacing is this one, where ASH is 1994. You can take the reference of it, if you wish to take the reference. So, spacing is going to be 314 divided by 997 multiplied by 1000, and if you just calculate, yes, you will get it around 314 divided by 997, and here you will get it around 315 mm. So you can provide it something rounded down. So 20 mm, let's say 300 mm center to center. And now we can provide the reinforcement at the top. So let us provide. This was at the 2 meter below the tip. Now at top. So at top, minimum reinforcement criteria is 0.3% at the top. So you can write down minimum reinforcement is equal to 0.3%. So 0.3%, and therefore you can write down ASH minimum, and that is equal to zero point three percent of T, that is, or you can write down 0.3% thickness. So multiplied by thickness, we have provided around 170 mm. So if you just calculate here, you are getting it around 510 mm. So this is the minimum you got, and for that you can calculate spacing. So spacing is equal to area of one bar, as we got it here, 314. So 314 divided by 510 multiplied by 1000, we are getting at around 600 mm. Now there is check to for the spacing, that should not be greater than 3 times thickness. So that is 3 multiplied by 170, so that is going to be 510 mm. And therefore, we cannot provide more than 510 mm. So we have to provide it other than that. So we can write down. Providing 20 mm diameter bar at 500 mm center to center. So that's it all about the reinforcement at the different height. And we will calculate the vertical reinforcement and reinforcement at the base slab in the next video. So, thank you.